Welcome to NPAT 2017 analysis. First of all, the overview of the exam. Though the exam pattern, the breakup of question and everything was announced well in advance, we could observe there were slight deviations in the actual paper as compared to what was officially announced. First one, as per the official announcement and a demo test, it was mentioned that student will be allowed to switch over the sections in between and choose a section of their choice. However, on the actual day of exam, the same could not happen and student had to attempt whichever section was presented to them first. On the day of exam, the first section was numerical ability, second section was reasoning and general intelligence, and third section was English proficiency. There were sectional time limits and the same was maintained by the exam. So in the first section, the sectional time limit was 45 minutes, second that is reasoning was again 45 minutes and third that is English proficiency was again 30 minutes. So this was as per the expectation. However, the deviations were within the section and there was slight confusion with reference to negative marking because there was no mention of negative marking or no negative marking at the time of announcement of the exam pattern and the demo test. However, on the day of exam, it was mentioned clearly that there is no negative marking. This would have slightly surged the number of attempts on the last moment. Let us review each section one by one. First of all, numerical ability. Though exam breakup mentioned that there will be only 4 questions on trigonometry, ratios and height and distance, a lot of students observed that the number of questions from trigonometry and height and distance were much higher than 4. Similarly, the breakup also mentioned the weightage of arithmetic and geometry mensuration based question will be around 16 questions out of 40, but the same was not 16 and a lot of students complained that it was less than 16. Another surprising element was very high weightage on algebra based question and most of the question were lengthy and because they were, most of the question were word problems and not based directly on the equation. This would have blocked a lot of attempts, especially from the students who are from commerce section or students who have not opted for pure maths as their subject during plus 2. The student hoping to pounce upon the basic arithmetic and basic geometry or mensuration based problems or questions based on numbers or question based on basic algebra could have been slightly disappointed. However, considering there was no negative marking and there was a time limit and everybody was supposed to attempt a quantitative section within that 45 minutes. So considering all these factors, we can safely assume that the good attempts will be somewhere around 24 to 25 questions out of 40 questions in the given time limit of 45 minutes. As there was no negative marking, we can estimate the good score in this section to be somewhere around 22 to 23. Assuming that 24-25 good attempts that we just mentioned are the genuine attempts, overall the number of attempts can be slightly higher because there was no negative marking. Reasoning section was more or less on the expected lines, except that the question based on DI were not into a group question of 5-5 each, though there were total 10 questions, but they were divided into 3 to 4 graph of 2 to 3 questions each. Similarly, questions on data sufficiency were also slightly tricky, otherwise it cannot be considered as actually tough, but they were slightly tricky in nature. Question on visual reasoning were officially announced to be 4, but student could not find 4 such questions on visual reasoning. Even the questions on numerical reasoning were less. Question on analytical reasoning and decision making were slightly lengthy because they were also not in the group question, except for decision making, which had one set of 5 questions. Most of the reasoning based questions or puzzle based questions were either single or in a group of 2 questions each. So this would have taken the attempts down, though the level of difficulty remained moderate to easy, but the number of attempts could not have been achieved which they could have achieved last year. So out of 40 questions which were supposed to be answered in 45 minutes, we can estimate the good attempts to be somewhere around 30-32 and a good score to be somewhere around 28. English proficiency section was also more or less on the expected lines except for reading comprehension, which as per their official pattern was supposed to be 3 passages of 5-5 question each, but we could observe some deviation here where number of passages were 4 in some instances or number of passages were 3 in some instances, though the total number of questions were 15, but the breakup changed and it was not as per the pattern. Overall, the level of difficulty of all the passages were very easy. Questions based on grammar were also really easy. So he had both the types of question, that is sentence correction based question and error detection based question. Both of them were easy. Question based on vocabulary was not direct. So there were no mention of direct synonym or antonym based question, but word usage in the form of appropriate or inappropriate sentence and question based on filling the blanks can be considered as easy. So looking at the level of difficulty, we can safely say that it was very much possible to attempt almost 40 out of 40 questions in 30 minutes. But considering genuine attempts and students who would want to keep very high accuracy, we can consider good attempts to be somewhere around 34-35 and a good score to be somewhere around 30. Looking at an overall scenario, a good score in the in this exam can be somewhere around 75 to 80. Now, as NMIMS or NPAT doesn't give official scores, they just give ranking. We have to consider the ranking for different courses. So we have provided a table over here where we have listed the courses like BBA, BSc Finance, BSc Economics and BCom Honors. And we have also tagged different campuses where these courses are offered. So please refer to the table given, and an estimated score for different courses at different campuses is also given in this table. Wishing you all the best for final result. Thank you.